I know what my father was, what he did. I know the Mad King earned his name.
Burn them all! Kill every Targaryen I get my hands on.
Everyone who isn't us is an enemy.
Sir Illyn, bring me his head.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back for another A Song of Ice and Fire Theory video. Today I want to talk about Melisandre's character from the books, because there is some evidence that may suggest she has already died at least once and been resurrected. Also, make sure you stay until the end of the video, because I am going to announce the two winners of the giveaway. Now, in the books and in the TV show, we have several different characters that have died and came back to life in a sense. During an interview with Time magazine, George R. R. Martin was talking about some of his characters that have came back from the dead, and how they were changed each time they came back. George said, "If someone comes back from the dead, especially if they suffer a violent, traumatic death, they're not going to come back as nice as ever. That's what I was trying to do, and am still trying to do, with the Lady Stoneheart character." And poor Beric Dondarrion, who was set up as the foreshadowing of all of this. Every time, he's a little less Beric. His memories are fading, he's got all these scars, he's becoming more and more physically hideous, because he's not a living human being anymore. His heart isn't beating, his blood isn't flowing in his veins. He's a wight, but a wight animated by fire instead of ice. Now we're getting back to the whole fire and ice thing. Of course, all of us were already familiar with wights, because they make up the majority of the Army of the Dead, but George R. R. Martin confirmed that Beric and Lady Stoneheart are wights as well. The only difference is they were animated by R'hllor, whereas the Ice Wights were animated by the Great Other, whatever that may be. What's interesting is the Ice Wights and the Fire Wights do have several things in common, although they are two opposing forces. When Beric Dondarrion, Lady Stoneheart, and even Coldhands are brought back from the dead, their bodies no longer function the same way they used to. And the same may even be said for Melisandre. I want to show you some quotes from the books, because I think it indicates that Melisandre was reanimated by R'hllor, just like Beric and Catelyn. Thankfully, Bran Stark was able to spend some time with Coldhands, because this gives us a lot of insight into how this character's body actually functions. And this may help us understand a little more about the Wights beyond the Wall, but it doesn't sound too different from the Fire Wights that were animated by R'hllor. The first connection I want to point out is that none of these characters ever seem to need to sleep. This is something Bran notices about Coldhands while they are traveling to Bloodraven's cave. This is what Bran says. "It's true. Bran had been afraid to speak of it, but he had noticed. Whenever they took shelter for the night, while he and Hodor and the Reeds huddled together for warmth, the Ranger kept apart. Sometimes Coldhands closed his eyes, but Bran did not think he slept. When Arya Stark is with Beric Dondarrion, she notices he doesn't sleep either." This is what it says in Arya's chapter. "He did not seem to sleep either. His good eye would often close, as if from weariness, but when you spoke to him, it would flick open again at once." The same thing could be said for Lady Stoneheart as well. When Brienne is with the Brotherhood Without Banners, Thoros makes a comment about this. This is what he says. "She returned while we were sleeping. She never sleeps herself." Since they've all been brought back from the dead, they no longer need to rest like a normal human being would. Now let's take a look at what it says about Melisandre when she thinks about sleeping. In Melisandre's POV chapter, this is what she thinks. "Dawn. Another day is given us. R'hllor be praised. The terrors of the night recede." Melisandre had spent the night in her chair by the fire, as she often did. With Stannis gone, her bed saw little use. She had no time for sleep, with the weight of the world upon her shoulders. And she feared to dream. Sleep is a little death. Dreams the whisperings of the other, who would drag us all into his eternal night. Some nights she drowsed, but never for more than an hour. One day, Melisandre prayed, she would not sleep at all. One day she would be free of dreams. Melanie, she thought. Lot 7. It sounds like it's the same thing that happens with Beric and Coldhands. Their eyes will close, but they never actually sleep. Now, let's take a look at another connection between these characters. When Bran is with Coldhands, he also notices that he never needs to eat or drink either. This is what it says about Coldhands. "He hides his face, and will not speak a name. Who is he? What is he? Anyone can put on a black cloak. Anyone or anything. He does not eat. He never drinks. He does not seem to feel the cold." Then again, in another chapter it says this. "The Ranger killed a pig. Coldhands stood behind the door, a raven on his arm, both staring at the fire. Reflections from the flames glittered off four black eyes. He does not eat, Bran remembered, and he fears the flames. When Arya Stark is with Beric Dondarrion, she notices the same thing about him as well, and this is what it says in her chapter. Lord Beric himself did not eat. Arya had never seen him eat, though from time to time he took a cup of wine. It seems pretty clear that when a person is brought back from the dead, their body no longer needs the same amount of rest or nourishment that a normal living person would need, and I suppose this does make sense. Now let's take a look at what it says about Melisandre, because she doesn't seem to ever need to eat either. Melisandre thought, food, yes, I should eat. Someday she forgot. R'hllor provided her with all the nourishment her body needed, but that was something best concealed from mortal men. This is the most interesting quote I want to show you because it could reveal a few different things. For one, Melisandre has to remind herself to eat because she doesn't need to, but she doesn't want the people to notice that. So she will sometimes eat in front of the people, but then she says, that was something best concealed from mortal men, which means she doesn't consider herself as being one. Melisandre's not mortal like most of the other characters, and that is kinda obvious when you find out she is hundreds of years old. But since she doesn't need to eat or sleep, she may be a fire white just like Beric Dondarrion and Lady Stoneheart. There is another connection between these characters that I want to point out, and this is the color of their blood. When Beric Dondarrion is fighting the Hound, he received a fatal wound, and this is what it says. Arya shrieked, but the burning sword snapped in two, and the Hound's cold steel plowed into Lord Beric's flesh, where his shoulder joined his neck, and clove him clean down to the breastbone. The blood came rushing out in a hot black gush. When Beric Dondarrion bleeds, his blood is black instead of red. When Lady Stoneheart is described, this is what it says about her. Half her hair was gone, and the rest had turned as white and brittle as a crone's. Beneath her ravaged scalp, her face was shredded skin, and black blood where she had raked herself with her nails. But her eyes were the most terrible thing. Her eyes saw him, and they hated. Beric Dondarrion has black blood, and Lady Stoneheart has black blood. Now let's take a look at what it says about Melisandre when she bleeds. When she gives birth to the Shadow Baby, this is what it says. Panting, she squatted and spread her legs. Blood ran down her thighs, black as ink. Her cry might have been agony or ecstasy or both. Everything about Melisandre is red. She has red hair, she has red eyes, and she's called the Red Woman. But when she bleeds, her blood is black, just like Beric's and Lady Stoneheart's. Could this be another clue that Melisandre has also been reanimated by R'hllor? In the television show, Melisandre hides her true identity by glamoring herself with her necklace. When she takes it off, we see her in her true form, which is a very old woman. But in the books, we haven't had this reveal yet. I am thinking when she takes her necklace off in the books, it may reveal that she looks as hideous as Lady Stoneheart. I know this doesn't prove Melisandre has already died, but when you compare some of her characteristics with other characters that we know have been brought back from the dead, I think there is a case to be made. Also, just keep in mind, this is a theory for the books, not for the TV show, because they have obviously made their own changes to these characters. But put your thoughts down below. Do you think Melisandre could be a Firewhite based on some of the things I've shown you today? Let me know what you think. Now let's move on to the winners of the giveaway. Both names were randomly selected, and if you take a look at the screen, you will see who won. The first name that is drawn will get to choose which prize they want. Then the second name that is drawn will get whatever prize that was not chosen. I have the Game of Thrones Blu-ray box set and the A Song of Ice and Fire book set. If your name gets selected, make sure you send me an email, otherwise I won't know where to ship either prize. Okay, so the first place winner of the giveaway is Nisha Garced. Congratulations, you will get to pick whichever prize you want. Just make sure you contact me via email. The second place winner of the giveaway is Kelly Tupick. Congratulations, Kelly. Whichever prize Nisha does not select will go to you. If you were not selected, don't worry because I plan on doing this again very soon. I want to thank everyone for watching the video, I really appreciate that. And I also want to thank everyone on Patreon for continuing to support my channel. Have a great day. I'll see you again very soon. Bye.